Hello and welcome to this episode of SAP Code Talk. I'm Shilpa Shankar, Developer Advocate. I'm your host and today's guest is Raja Gupta, Solution Architect with SAP Labs India, a fellow blogger and author of number of books on SAP BTP and SAP HANA. Today's topic is a quick glimpse on generative AI. Well, we hear about AI in every context. Let me assure you, this is not some technical discussion, but rather a simple generic talk in the layman's term. So before we get started, welcome Raja to this code talk. And could you briefly introduce yourself about your role and the passion that you have for blogging and authoring number of SAP books?
Thank you, Shilpa. And hello, everyone. So as Shilpa said, I'm a solution architect in partner engineering team, where we guide SAP partners to build innovations on SAP BTP, S/4HANA, etc. Apart from my core work, I also have a passion for learning new technologies and sharing my knowledge. In fact, I feel more alive when I connect with an audience. For my learning, I follow a very simple yet effective rule, which is spend daily at least 30 minutes to learn something new. Consistency is the key here, and it works wonder for me. And I always make sure that whatever I learn, I share that, you know, in either in the forms of blog or post or, if possible, book. Writing blogs is like, you know, a stress buster for me.
Well, actually, that's a wonderful message, what you said about learning and just keeping aside some 30 minutes every day to learn something new. And when you told about that you feel alive when you connect with the audience, and to me personally, what I enjoy about my current role is the same, that when I connect with SAP customers or the partners to actually know what is happening outside of an SAP, that gives a fulfillment, saying like, okay, I feel very positive and it gives a very good feeling. So and that's a wonderful positive message what you started with. So with that, let's get into our topic for today.
Sure.
And let's begin with the basic first, Raja. So what is generative AI and how it's different from traditional AI?
Sure. In fact, it's important to understand these basic concepts before you jump to the generative AI with SAP, you know, talk. Mm-hmm. Let's first understand what exactly is AI. AI is nothing but enabling computer to think like human. Or we can say it's about enabling computer to do those tasks which otherwise require human intelligence. For example, an AI program to play chess can make a move in the game, can plan a strategy, or even defeat a human world champion. However, there is a major limitation with the traditional AIs. Mm-hmm. These AI systems are focused only on one task. For example, this AI program to play chess cannot suddenly start playing a new game, or it cannot generate a new game until unless it's trained for that. Or we can say that this AI system lacks creativity. And that's exactly where generative AI comes into the picture. Generative AI is like a curious mind as we human have. It can generate new text, new images, new videos, even something like poetry or music as we human do. To summarize, we can say that while AI is like a super smart program which can do anything it has been trained for, generative AI is a smart, creative person who can generate new things.
Yeah, actually, that was a simple way to explain it. So with that, can you, from your perspective, can you please elaborate SAP's strategy to incorporate AI into enterprise solution?
Sure. Before understanding SAP's AI strategy, let's try to understand one important point. SAP's core strength is in enterprise solution, business data, and the business processes. So SAP customers, they expect SAP to solve business problems more effectively and innovatively. So considering that in mind, SAP is not competing with general purpose AI platforms or LLM vendors. Rather, SAP is focusing on using AI to solve real life business problems. There are two major parts of SAP's AI strategy. First, SAP is building embedded AI capabilities inside its own solution, like S4HANA or SuccessFactors. So customer they can reap the benefit of AI without having any additional development or without any having any additional licenses. It's like just configure and use the AI in context of your business data and your business processes. Second important part of the strategy is SAP is providing several AI services on BTP. This is to enable customers and partners to build their own solution on BTP where they need to incorporate AI so that they are not, they don't need any third-party license. They don't need to go underlying the implementation behind those services. It's like just subscribe the service and use it and have the power of AI.
Okay, so now that you have touched upon business application and putting AI into the context of business, what is SAP Business AI?
Interesting term. It's important to understand that SAP Business AI is not a solution. Rather, it's a portfolio of SAP's AI application and SAP AI services, which are running and powered by BTP. In other words, we can say that SAP Business AI is the way SAP is looking forward in AI, is the way SAP is infusing the power of AI inside its own solution, while also enabling customer and partner to do the same.
So then how does SAP BTP fits into this AI game? Like what are the major AI services SAP BTP provides? And how are they relevant for SAP partners and customers?
As I explained in the previous question, the second part, the one of the main part of SAP's AI strategy is SAP is providing several ready-to-use business-relevant AI services on BTP. Now, let's understand that more with an example. Say I am a customer or a partner, and I want to build either a new solution on BTP or I want to extend our SAP solution, like extension of S4HANA. And I want to incorporate several AI capabilities inside my own application on BTP. And at the same time, I want to do that without having any third-party license, without going into the technical details of those AI services. So to solve this scenario, SAP is providing several services on BTP. So BTP here acts like an AI foundation, which enable all the customers and the partners to use AI without any technical difficulties. It's like a reusable component, just subscribe and use it inside your own application. Let's take an example to understand more. See, a customer is building a solution on BTP and they want to use machine learning to automate document information extraction process. So for that, instead of implementing this from scratch or using a third-party API, they can just go to BTP, subscribe a service called Document Information Extraction. It's a service ready to use, usable, and you can just subscribe, call the API, and have the power of this API inside your application. Another example could be, say, you want to build an application where you want to utilize machine learning to provide a personalized experience for a user based on their browser history. Now, this is not a very uncommon use case, but what SAP is providing you is that a ready-made service which helps you to implement this without going into the technical complexity of this scenario. The service name is personalized recommendation. On the same line, there are several other services as well, like SAP AI Code, SAP AI Launchpad, and so on.
Yeah, actually, that personalized recommendation is what it's quite strong, right? I mean, whenever we want some the recommendations that we are interested in, and that has a great value. So with that, thank you, Raja, for taking time to share your thoughts on generative AI and touching upon business AI with examples. It was nice having you for a short code talk. Thank you.
Same here. Thank you, Shilpa.
Thank you, everyone, for watching.